هيا هيا إخوة الإيمان هيا لسبيل الله ما أحلى المنية هيا هيا إخوة الإيمان هيا
إخوة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praises due to Allah Azza wa Jal, first and foremost. It is Him alone that we praise, it is Him alone that we seek for help, and it is Him alone that we ask for His forgiveness. For whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, there is none that can misguide them. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to go astray, then there are none that can bring them to guidance. I testify that there is absolutely no deity, no creature in existence that should be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing has a right to be worshipped except Allah. And it is Him alone that should be worshipped. I also testify at the same time that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's servant and His messenger. When we say La ilaha illallah, we are in fact testifying to that fact that I just want to deal with briefly. Nothing absolutely has a right to be worshipped except Allah. And this is the whole entire essence of the life of the Muslim. For in order for his heart to be cleansed, any individual in this life, anyone from mankind, in order for their heart to be cleansed, in order for their heart to be pure, that essence of La ilaha illallah, the meaning of which is in Arabic, La ma'bud bihaq illallah. Nothing has a right to be worshipped except Allah. That essence must be inside the heart of the person, of the individual. And then the heart will be cleansed. Then the heart will be on a path to their Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, mentioning about the Day of Judgment, or mentioning about the situation on Yawm al-Qiyamah, about that day, يَوْمْ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. So on that day, after this life is finished, after the dunya is finished, this life of glitter, of glamour, amusement and play, after it is finished, then nothing will benefit the person except the one who came with a pure and straight and correct heart. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. And also, part of that essence of La ilaha illallah, as you know, part of it, or connected to it, along with it, is the testimony that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's servant and His messenger. And the abd, or the servant of Allah, cannot attain that qalb, salim, cannot attain a purified heart without Muhammad Rasulullah. I say it again, by Allah, the individual, the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, cannot attain that qalb salim, that purified heart, a heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept into paradise on Yawm al-Qiyamah, except with Muhammad Rasulullah. And that is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's part of La ilaha illallah. There's no guidance, we always testify. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there's no way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to His pleasure, to His ridwan, the ridwan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except by Muhammad Rasulullah. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us over and over in the Quran, أَطِيُّ اللَّهِ وَأَطِيُّ الرَّسُولِ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولِ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. And whoever obeys the Rasul, they have obeyed Allah. So they're together. They both go along with each other. And if anybody wants to find the path to paradise, the path to cleansing their heart, it is in following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Many people today, we look around, even in the Muslim community, we're often busy with looking for cures for ailments or sicknesses. And people are looking and making research now on the internet, researching what is the natural cure for such and such a disease. They don't want to take medication anymore because medication is not working. Or they don't want to take a certain medication anymore. Or they're looking for a natural cure. They're looking for a cure for cancer. And some people have beaten cancer. Some people have been diagnosed with cancer. And then months later, it's gone, it's disappeared. And people are looking for cures for sicknesses and ailments. But how many are the people? And Allah knows best. How many are the people that are looking for a cure for what is in the hearts? Not the physical heart as in an ailment of the heart like a blockage of the arteries and so on. Not those sicknesses. But like the sicknesses that Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about? Heart disease? لا والله. The sickness of hypocrisy or nifaq. The sickness of in the hearts of kibr, arrogance. The sickness of the hearts of not accepting the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it is clear, when it is made plain to them. Misguidance, dalal. Sicknesses of the heart. Choosing blindness over seeing. Choosing darkness over light. Choosing falsehood over truth. Ha! These sicknesses. How many are those? And especially the Muslims first. The Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We all say we believe La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. But how many of the Muslims, how many are looking for cures for those sicknesses that we may have in our heart, or we may have specks of it, we may have traces of it growing, and you know, like that ran, like it's mentioned in the surah, كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ. That spot, or that speck, that the Prophet ﷺ explained, that when the son of Adam, Ibn Adam, when he does a sin, when they do dhunub, when they do ma'asi, disobedience to Allah Azza wa Jal, عَذَنَ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكُمْ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. When they do disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a speck, a black spot is placed on the heart, is accumulated on the heart. That's what the Prophet ﷺ said. And do you know why? When you go to Mecca, when you go to the Hajj, or you go to Umrah, and you see the Hajj al-Aswad, the hajr, what color? Black. Because of the sins of the son of Adam. The hajr al-aswad used to be originally what? Used to be white. Because of the sins of the sons of Adam. As he said, alayhi afdalu salati wa salam. So this ran, this speck that goes on the hearts of the sons of Adam, when they sin, when they disobey Allah, and they don't make tawbah, they don't turn away, they don't fix that, they don't purify their heart, then those black dots, they accumulate.